ka jilla Meghalaya kala sakhi ka jingki rasong ha ka jing don jongki nong di drong kata na ka ar sha ka lailak ngot wat hadin baksor ka jilla kala mang hadu sanpho klur tingka banya khon persha yaki kam khai drug but ban bo shu shu yaki jakaya slok ni rehabilitation center ha ka jilla haba pentip yakani ha ka juba jong u hapo ka yeng dor bar assembly u mintri bakhmi yakatna social welfare uba polling door ulong katkum ka jingwat benia ka batthmai kidan hadu kumba lailak ngot ki briu ki blakerni ha ki jing di drug ha ka jela nadu balas dang yak drug reduction elimination and action mission DREAM ka sarkar jela kala bo pisa hadu sanpho kur tingka banya khun prasha yak jingma naki kam khai drug laong ulapente pru balingba ka DREAM ka sarkar jela kala yai ru na ka banta ban thau shu shu yak jaka sumar The Addiction Center habaro kawe kajala. Kumba kalong menta light no tang ka East Cars Hills District la itu yakiwe pat ki district panbo yakini kijaka sumar ula benram. Haluar ka jing sngok kya bala penpao dakil yang persya hakabaya dey baka jing yok pisa kabaduna bha na ka sorkar pedeng banya kon persya ya udrong uba pol ula ong. Da ladi hi shimet ngalala banya keren bat ketanat ha Delhi but ngan sakhat chen ya u menteri badai kmi maria kot kani ka dorbar na kaliang u mla ka vpp no nongkrem uba arden miller basaimon ulapun pa ko jingso kya ka bajor halor ka jingshar ke jong udrok ha kani ka jilla da ka bakentu ya ka sorkar bakan simkia ban wat pisa shu shu na ka sorkar pdeng nang ban lap nuwing ya kani ka jing e Halor ka jing kwa tip jong uba arden ba ha kanu ko nong rim ka sorkar ka kam ba ka jing job ha ka jing akun persha ya udrok ka long kumba arpo percent uba pol ula ong ba ka long halor ka jing lumbnia ya ka jing tip bat ki jing khen jing dia bala yo de ki bor sorkar bat ki kin hun shimen kam de ka jing kam ka ba he da ka sorkar namar ka ni ka long kat kum ki jing yo lum ya ka jing khen jing dia ka jing le ya ki sorbe bat ki jing wat bnia ula benram kam hashwa uba polling do ula pentip bagi dan hadu shipo tadi ke jaka rehabilitation center ha ka jela nakini real tadi ke center la kershan dak sor ka jela lingba ka tra social welfare lingba ka jinga tre lang jingi kin hun shimet but ki seng 3 months ngo bha ki bala shampang halor ka ni ka banta ula pentip ru bagi dan santali ke rehabilitation center ha east cars hills district hak balai tadi ki dek bla ajing arab tak sorkar pedeng bat ka wei pat ka dek bla penya dak ka kun hun shimen
Mr. Speaker sir the total number of rehabilitation centers in the state of Meghalaya is 10 b the total number of drug addiction rehabilitation centers that have been set up in east Khas Hills district is 5
Speaker sir May I know from the Honorable Minister in charge of Social Welfare, regarding this rehabilitation centers, where are they located? Are they fully operational, sir? Only in the East Cassis?
Yes, sir. The centers in East Cassis, funded by the state government, are as follows. Kripa Foundation D Addiction Center for Children, for Boys at Mau Kasiang, New Shillong, East Khas Hills. Number two, KJPA New Hope D Addiction Center for Women, Mau Kasiang, New Shillong, East Khas Hills District. Three, New Life D Addiction Center for Men, Om Jarang, KJP Sinod Sabni Urban Mission, Mau Tawar, Shillong, East Khas Hills. Centers funded by the central government. One, KGP New Hope De Addiction Center for Men, Mau Kasiang, New Shillong, East Khas Hills District. Centers privately managed. One, Sun Care for both men and women, Mau Lai Mau Ro, East Khas Hills, Shillong, East Khas Hills District. Yes.
So, what is the total strength of staff in each of these centers, and what are the different professional backgrounds?
As far as manpower is concerned, the centers conform to the National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction, which is a scheme supported by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Government of India. As far as the professional qualifications, all of the staff of these centers are professionals having qualified under different courses and mainly catering to psychotherapy and psychotherapy and physiotherapies. And the total number as per the guidelines under the National Action Plan ranges from 7 to 10.
Do we know the numbers of the drugs addict in the state and also give the numbers of successful cases being treated in these centers?
So as far as the latest surveys indicate, there would be roughly almost 3 lakh numbers of drug addicts in the state. And as far as treatment is concerned, all of the patients referred to these centers are treated as per their condition, and they would be released from these centers based on recommendations by the professional doctors.
Just have replied to one question. The number of successful cases being treated in these centers.
So it's a very exhaustive statement, but I would just like to cite some instances. For example, in the district of West Jaintia Hills, we have in 2020 to 21 patients treated, 21, 22, 55, 22, 23, 65, 23, 24, 131, altogether 272 cases. And the number of patients admitted is determined by the availability of beds and the duration of their stay.
Thank you, sir. One more supplementary question. So we'll like to know the types of drugs being recorded in the last 5 years.
So it's a whole range of drugs, beginning from drugs that are considered to be at the entry level, up to drugs of very highly toxic, and so the range includes all types of drugs and narcotics that are used across the country, and it's again a very exhaustive list of such drugs. But in most cases, sir, the treatment that is being offered caters to the different types of diseases that emanate from the use of such drugs.
Yes, pardon, please.
Sir, we know that the issue on drugs, especially the menace of drugs, has become a nightmare for the state. And as per the reply of the minister, he had mentioned that the total number of addicts till today, sir, is around 3 lakhs. So which has shown that the rise is alarming. Because if I'm not mistaken, in this house only, we discussed last year, and when we talk about the number of addicts, we were informed that it is around 2 lakh, something like that. So the increase is alarming, sir. So, sir, since the number of addicts is 3 lakhs, according to the reply of the minister, may I know from the minister, would the minister please give the breakup of addicts, how many of them are dependent on depressant drugs, and how many of them, out of 3 lakhs, how many of them are dependent on depressant drugs, and how many of them dependent on stimulant drugs?
So that figure is not readily available with me, so I would require notice.
So under the National Action Plan for Drugs Demand Reduction, NAP-DDR, which is a central sponsored scheme being implemented by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, financial assistance is being given to the states, to different states in India. So may I know how much the state of Meghalaya has received this assistance under this scheme, sir, till today?
Sir, under the DREAM mission, which is the acronym for the Drug Reduction, Elimination and Action Mission, the state government has moved for the creation of more de-addiction centers throughout the state of Meghalaya. As of today, except for East Khas Hills districts, the rest of the districts in the state have been identified as gap districts for setting up of district de-addiction centers and addiction treatment facilities in government health settings. We have moved for the creation of de-addiction centers for males in West Garo Hills, detoxification center in Riboy district, de-addiction center for females in West Jayanti Hills, de-addiction centers in West Jayanti Hills and West Garo Hills, setting up of 3 outreach and drop-in centers in Riboy, West Khas Hills and West Garo Hills districts, setting up of 4 community peer-led intervention in West Garo Hills, Riboy, East Jayanti Hills and Southwest Khas Hills, and setting up of de-addiction centers in prison settings in West Jayanti Hills, West Garo Hills and Riboy districts. So these are currently part of our action plan, sir.
So, sir, the minister is not getting my question. I'm asking a simple question. How much the state of Meghalaya has received the financial assistance under this program so far till today?
Sir, till 2021-22, the state government has received a total sanction of 1,30,000 rupees only for the fiscal year 2021-22.
Since the issue is very serious, and may I know whether the government has moved the center to allocate more funds under these schemes? Because comparing to other states, the amount received by the state of Meghalaya is too meager, sir. So has there been any attempt on the part of the state government to move that more funds should be given under this program?
Sir, the concern raised by the honourable member is very laudable. I believe that he and the rest of this House will also appreciate the fact that a new government has just taken over at the centre, and already attempts have been made on the part of the government of Meghalaya to access more funding from the ministry in order for us to be able to tackle the problem on a war footing.
So why I'm asking this question, sir, is the same question, sir, it's just a supplement. Because a state like Manipur, they received, in 2021, they received 6.34 crores. And in 2021-22, 7.2 crores. And in 2022-23, 7.63 crores. Whereas the state of Meghalaya, as per the information available, is receiving only 0.12 in 2021 and 0.18 in 2023. And there are other northeastern states who receives more under this program, which is why I'm asking whether the government should not find excuse. This is not the new government in Delhi. It is a continuation of the old government. So that should not be the excuse for the government, if the government is really serious on this matter, sir. So anyway, sir, another question that I would like to ask the minister is this. Recently, the minister had claimed that the government of Meghalaya has been able to successfully combat the drugs menace in the state by 20%, where it has surpassed the average, the national average. So may I know from the Honorable Minister, how do the government of Meghalaya know that the success rate in combating drugs is 20%? What kind of survey that the government has conducted, or on what basis?
Sir, to reply to the earlier query of the Honorable Member, it is true that the government at the center is a continuation of the earlier regime. But then it is also equally true that a new council of ministers has taken over, meaning that there is a new minister in charge. There has been a change in the bureaucratic setup. And also the fact that on our own, since the launch of the Dream Mission, the state government has earmarked a total amount of 50 crore rupees on our own to combat the menace of drug trafficking, apart from accessing funding from the center, for which I will personally, I have already managed to establish contacts with the ministry in Delhi, and will be calling on the minister in charge as soon as this session is over. Two, where the figure of the reduction is concerned, these are all based on official statistics available with us, and I will be happy to share those statistics with the House.
Yes, Bob Restowell.
May I know from the Minister in Charge of Social Welfare, the total capacity intake in these 10 centres that you have just mentioned?
Sir, in each of these centers, which I have named, there is an average intake capacity of 15 to 20 patients.
I'm not satisfied, sir, with the reply of the Honorable Minister, because what I'm asking, sir, is how the government arrived.
You have completed five.
No, no, sir. This is because I'm not satisfied, sir. He hasn't addressed my question, sir.
Please go ahead.
So I'm asking how the government arrived at the 20% success rate. So what is the methodology? Whether is there any survey, any agency that the government is engaging? You cannot simply say that it depends on the statistics provided by the government. We want to know how the government arrived at the 20%, which you have
claimed. You may address the House.
Yes, sir.
I mean, okay. The Speaker. Chair, please.
Sorry, sir.
Sir, the figures that led us to this conclusion were based on a comprehensive collection of data and statistics sourced from different agencies, both government and private. And at the end of this survey, it has been shown that the success rate in tackling the problem of drug addiction and narcotics in Meghalaya is around 20%, and this is all based on these various surveys conducted, after which we arrived at this figure. So it is not just a tall claim made by the government, it is based on surveys, statistics, and researches done.
So, may I request the Honourable Minister to please play that on the table of the House, that entire reply?
Yes, sir. I'll be ready in, give me a day's time.
Okay, you can, since this is a very lengthy statement, you can lay it on the table of the House.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If Mr. Bryce Trowell, you may continue with your second supplementary, okay, please.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I would also like to know, thank you for the reply from the Honourable Minister, that the intake capacity in these 10 centres is, if we take 20 in each centre, then it will come only around 200. But then, as the Minister himself has just mentioned in the floor of the House, that the number of edicts is 3 lakhs in the state. So when you look at the gap, it's too meagre. I would like to know how much the amount that the government have been able to assist or spend in these 10 institutions. What are the different helps that the government is being is given to these 10 institutions?
So the various kinds of interventions include counseling, medical intervention, as well as post-treatment counseling. And we also have introduced courses for the various centers where livelihood skills are also taught at those centers.
I think the Honorable Minister did not get the question that I'm asking. In fact, I want to know the amount that the government spent on these 10 institutions.
So the figure is not readily available with me, but I can assure the member that the treatment of all of these patients is very exhaustive, and a patient is only allowed to leave once we are satisfied that he is in a condition to be considered a normal citizen who is drug free.
In fact, I'm not satisfied with the answer, but nonetheless, the minister himself had stated just now that the government had spent around 50 crores as far as combating drugs in the state is concerned. So I would like to know from the minister the breakup of this 50 crores.
Please,
where have they spent?
Please address the chair, please.
So I have stated that under the DREAM mission, there is a sanction of 50 crores to be spent in the next 5 years, beginning with 5 crores during the current fiscal year.
Yes, sir.
Speaker, the next sir, supplementary.
I would like specifically to know how much the government has spent from this 50 crores as far as these 10 centres is concerned. Why I'm asking? Because, as we are aware, in fact, Meghalaya, we have been suffering a lot from the problem of drugs. In fact, that 3 lakhs drugs users in the state. In fact, in the last meeting, which has been chaired by the Minister in charge of social welfare, I have stated even then that if the government is serious as far as combating drugs is concerned, it has to be more proactive. Why I'm saying this? Because if we take, for example, in the state of Tripura, where they have a multi-layer treatment facilities. In fact, they have come up with a central level rehabilitation center at the cost of rupees 121 crores. And apart from that, they have de-addiction centers in all districts of Tripura under the Subarna Jayanti Tripura Nirma scheme, where the state has sanctioned 20 crores for each facilities. And apart from that, there is also around 5 de-addiction centers which have been sponsored by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So I would like to see from the government of the day, from the government of Meghalaya, that it take concrete, proactive actions as far as combating drugs is concerned. And we should look at Tripura as an example. The way the government is very much active. So I would like to know from the minister specifically what is the amount that have been given to these 10 institutions.
So in the course of my reply, I made it very clear that the DREAM mission envisages a total allocation of 50 crores over the next 5 years, meaning till 2027-28. And the fact that we are on a mission mode where there is convergence between the departments of social welfare, health, home police, indicates the seriousness with which we are tackling the problem. So wherever there is a deficit of attention as of date, I have also indicated that the government has already approached the center to ensure that under the National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction, all the 12 districts of Meghalaya, which have not been covered by this de-addiction centers, will be covered. As of date, it is only East Khasi Hills, but we already have envisioned, and I have also stated the names of the centers that have been identified for the coverage of these new centers under different districts, and therefore that itself shows the seriousness with which we are tackling the problem, sir.
Okay, one last question from Mr. Rupa Marak, please.
Hello, sir. The course of the reply, Mr. Speaker, sir, I've come to know that there are 10 rehabilitation centers in our state. So may I know from the minister in charge, the number of rehabilitation centers in the Garo Hills region of our state?
So, under the with the support of the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, we have set up addiction treatment facilities. These include, in the Garo Hills, the addiction treatment facility at the Tura Civil Hospital, which is a 25-bedded facility, 13 beds for males and 12 for females. We also have the ATF at Bakmara Civil Hospital, South Garo Hills, and under the new mission, we are approaching the center for coverage of the rest of the districts under this de-addiction center.
Last question, please, but Albert Limbo. This question is taking very long.
No, sir, you cannot say that.
Let me ask only one question.
Why? Every member have the privilege of 5 questions, I mean, to take part in supplement.
You cannot. No, this question is taking very long time. There are so many other questions. Equally, the members have put in the questions. They expect to
the time. But this question, which is still going on.
I cannot take too much time on single question. Please, go ahead.
Okay, sir. So it's not a matter of jokes. 3 lakhs affected, affected by this drugs abuse. Okay, so may I seek a clarification from Honorable Minister through you, Mr. Speaker, sir? In regards with sizing of many substances by NDTF. Seizing by NDTF, where it had been kept, it never been shown in public, and whether it destroyed or it had been kept confidential.
If it's confidential, why? What's the reason behind? May I get clarification from Nobu, Mr.
Sir, in fact, there is no hide and seek at all. These drugs, once confiscated, they are inventorized, and where they are destroyed, this is also kept on record. And the honorable member may kindly recollect that in the last 5 months itself, one such incineration of drugs seized by the police had happened in a district, in a cement plant located at East Giant Hills District, after it has been, after all due diligence has been done to ensure that the place was safe. And this consignment of drugs seized and destroyed was also publicized by the state government, and pictures, including visuals of the drugs seized and their destruction thereafter, was also made public, sir.
As the water dreams is a good objective from the government, good initiative, but we don't know exactly whether this dream will come true, will come to reality or not. We would like to know, to get a clarification from Honorable Minister, because it's a huge number, 3 lakhs affected, which had been affected. May I know numbers of addicted? Please give district wise.
Sir, I can only indicate the fact that we have hotspots where drug addiction is at its peak, and these cover almost every district of the state. But let me say that the highest occurrence is in the state capital itself.
So I wonder, when I look at this reply, number B, all three in regards with the rehabilitation center, I couldn't see that it appear that aided by the own state government. It was aided by the state, by the center, by the private center. So I would like to get a specific clarification. Why not come up with a proper rehabilitation center, so that this will be a blessing, especially for those affected who cannot afford to get rid of this menace.
So I have named centers aided by the state government as 6. Kripa Foundation, De-Addiction Center for Children at Mau Kasiang, KGPA New Hope De-Addiction Center for Women Mau Kasiang, Breakthrough Center Kliat Trishi Village Jowai, West Giant Hills, KGPA Selda Center for Children Girls Nong Stoin West Khasi Hills, New Life De-Addiction Center for Men Umjaran KGP Sinod Sepni Urban Mission Mau Tawar Shillong, and 6 Kripa Foundation for Men at Nongsder Ribhoi. The total number of centers aided by the state government is 6, apart from ATF at Tura and ATF at Bakmara, which takes the total number to 8. So centers aided by the central government is only 1, the KGPA New Hope De-Addiction Center for Men at Mau Kasiang, New Shillong, East Khasi Hills. Centers privately managed are Sun Care for both men and women at Maulai Mauro, Thio Rehabilitation Center for Men at Lang Umshing, Nong Stoin, West Khasi Hills, and Wisdom Center at Umdihar, Ribhoi District. Currently, the state government is also supporting the Maulai Town Dorbar with a total sanction that has just touched 25 lakhs till date. And also, we are starting the outreach and drop-in center run by Manbha Foundation at Mentong, Jowai, West Gentile, sir.